Hey folks, in this video, we're gonna go over 17 ways you can use AI to make you more productive in 2024. A lot of these techniques and strategy I have been using for the past several months, or I've learned things from the various communities, and it has helped skyrocket my productivity. So I wanna share those things with you. So I'm not gonna do any how-tos in this video, I'm just gonna show you what's possible. And if it's something that you're interested in, just put it in the comments and I'll create a detailed tutorial to show you how to implement it into your own life. And you don't have to watch the whole video. I've included timestamps below so you can go by whichever stuff is important to you. Now, if you have ever tried to do something new or different, a lot of times the frustration, or the difficulty rather, is because you don't know where to start. But in this case, you have a friend that has read the whole internet, so it's gonna make it substantially more easy. So let's get into it. So before we jump all the way into AI or some things that you can use, first we need to know what is it that you want to accomplish. So here for 2024, I want you to do a brain dump. And all the brain dump is getting all of that information of what you want to accomplish and do, your desires, your goals, all of that, out of your head and into something tangible. So whatever works for you is the best way to do it. For me, I'm old school. I like to use good old pen and paper and write down everything that I want to accomplish. Do not worry about sentence structure. Don't worry about grammar. Don't worry about is it realistic or anything. Just get it out of your head and get it into something tangible. Now, you can actually use AI in this process if you want to, just getting the information out of your head. Like I said, I like to use pen and paper, but if you want to do a voice note, you can absolutely do that. Do a voice note into your phone and you can use something like Opening Eyes Whisper to transcribe it for free. Or you can go to one of my favorites that I've been using forever, and this is Google Docs. And so Google Docs, if you go over here to Tools, and then you come down here to Voice Typing, and then click to speak. And now in real time, you can have your thoughts transcribed so you can have something to work with. Now, after you've gone through the process of getting everything out of your head, your goals, your aspiration, everything you wanna accomplish for 2024, you wanna look at that list, and then from that list, you wanna put it into some type of order. And typically what that means is you're going to divide it into some type of duration. And then after you get it into a duration, then you can head over to a large language model, whichever one you prefer, and start to develop your plan. So this one, we're going to talk about what are the things that you feel that you can accomplish within the next 1 to 3 months. After 1 to 3 months, then you want to identify those tasks, goals, whatever, that you can do within 3 to 6 months. And then after that, you're going to do the ones that you can probably accomplish within 6 to 12 months. This is the order that will help things be a little less overwhelming. Okay, so now we're gonna type in a prompt. So here we're at ChatGPT, and of course you can use whatever LLM you want to use. I would recommend just having one conversation specifically for your goals and your check-in. So you can do your 1 to 3 months, and here we have a prompt. I'd like to complete the following projects within the next 90 days. Create and launch a new website, write 30 blog posts, study for Python programming for the intermediate exam. I work 8 hours and my daily commute is 2 hours a day. I may have 1 hour, 30 minutes to spare each day to accomplish a task. Can you help me create a daily to-do list to complete these tasks? So as you can see here, it gives you your week by week as to what you can accomplish, but then it gives you individual daily tasks that you can do for that day. So when it comes to writing your to-do list, instead of starting from a blank slate, you can actually come to ChatGPT and help talk it out as to how you can accomplish this within the time frame that you're interested in doing it. Now, do this with your 1 to 3 months, your 3 to 6 months, and your 6 months to 12 months. And I would recommend you could build a GTP specifically for your goals. If you don't know what that just meant, don't worry. But you can keep this one conversation specifically for your goals so that you can continue to check in. Now, ChatGPT is great for learning new skills. And for me, I had 2 skills that I wanted to learn within the past 6 months, and that was improve my Portuguese language skills and study Python programming language. So I'm going to show you how I did both those things. First, let's start with increasing my Portuguese language. And I felt like ChatGPT really helped me better understand things. You're a European Portuguese teacher. Your task is to help me with pronunciation. Please consider my native language is US English. Consider writing words phonetically to help me understand how to say the word correctly in European Portuguese. If there are any English words that sound like the European Portuguese word, feel free to use them as examples to help me better understand the correct pronunciation. Do you understand? So that was the prompt that worked for me. And what I thought was really helpful, it was someone whose first language was English explaining it to me and was able to explain the various nuances. So let me show you what that prompt produced. So if you can look at these, hola, bon dia, por favor, it explains it and it gives me phonetic words so I can say it correctly. This was game-changing in my language journey. So learning Python is another way that I used large language models, but I want you to understand how you can implement this in whatever you're wanting to learn. So if you're having difficulty with certain concepts, put them into the LLM, in this case, ChatGPT. So I was having a hard time understanding what functions, modules, and packages are. And if you ain't in the program, I'm not about to bore you with that. But it was able to explain it. And then in that, I say, can you give me some real world examples of how I would use that? And then I was able to understand it, because what I found in trying to learn a programming language is obviously most of the people teaching it are technical, and sometimes they've been technical for so long that when it comes to explaining beginner type stuff, you can get lost. So definitely use AI to embark on any new tasks that you are interested in. And you know what else is great about this? Like, you don't have to be embarrassed or share your vulnerability with someone else. If you don't know the answer, there really legitimately is no such thing as a stupid question. You can ask it here and get a level of understanding that you may not have ever been able to get before, and you're not going through 1600 blog articles to try to understand a concept. Now let's look at some health and wellness goals. So here we have a prompt. I want to increase muscle mass. This is how old I am, how much I weigh, next 90 days, that type of thing. So you wanna write this so it's very personal to you. Give it as much information as you possibly can so that something interesting can come out. So after that, let's see what we come up with. Now in it, I was very specific that I didn't wanna eat red meat, pasta, bread, or rice. So, in just a matter of seconds, ChatGPT is giving me a healthy meal plan based on the things that I said I would like to eat. Now, what I really, really loved about this is that when I ask it for a grocery list for the first 2 weeks of the meal plan, it prints it out in seconds. Here are the vegetables I need to buy. Here's the proteins, here's the grain. In seconds, all I have to do is copy this and put in my list and go to the grocery store. It has never been that easy. Another way you can use AI is to help you maintain your schedule. And this is critical, particularly if, like me, you live abroad and you are balancing a bunch of different time zones. Doing this in an automated way, just being able to give someone a link and book time with you is critical. Now, Reclaim AI will work with Google Calendar. If you don't have Google Calendar, it's okay. But the great thing about Reclaim AI is it finds these spaces where you may have availability and you can schedule things for life work balance. You can take a break, you can do lunch, you can prep, you can do all these things, and it will maneuver and kind of find the time based on those of you who have Google Calendar. Now, I don't use Google Calendar that often. Now, I use Acuity personally, which is an automated scheduling software, but they haven't incorporated much AI into their product lately. And I don't know if they will. If this is a little bit of old technology, maybe they'll upgrade. But for those of you who use Calendarly, Calendarly is in the process of putting AI into their scheduling. I'm not even sure what that means, but it's pretty exciting that they're embracing the new technology. So if you're with Calendarly, check it out. If you're using it, let me know. I would love to hear how they're incorporating large language models into their scheduling. So there's a lot going on in the world, and it's a lot of information that's getting thrown at you, and you may just really want to have your news personalized. Well, AI can do that. So here we're at Google News, and Google News is an aggregator of all the news that's going on worldwide. And you can go through it, get your information, get full coverage. But more importantly, you can also decide what type of news that you would like to see. So here you can hit the three dots and you can say more stories like this, less stories like this, or you can go for you, and it will aggregate the type of news that you like to enjoy. So I look at a lot of financial and business news, and that's what's popping up here. But if you really want to get super, super niche into things that are important to you, let's say it's sports, let's say it's the latest in AI, whatever it is, you can come here to Google News Alerts and fill this out and you can make sure that these things are getting directly to your inbox, things that are important to you and save you time. Now, another way that you can use AI to make your 2024 more productive is managing your email. So email can be a nightmare. If you are one of those people that has 7,000 emails on your app, this can help you tremendously. So let me show you how I use it. Now, I'm using a software called Make, which is a lot like Zapier, and this is a no-code software that helps you bring a bunch of different technology together. Don't worry if you don't know what that means. If you don't, I can do a detailed tutorial if that'll better help you. But let me just show you the functionality of it. So this was actually recommended by a fellow YouTuber by the name of Adrian. I will put his tutorial to his video that helped me add this. I made some adjustments that match my life, but his tutorial is great and I'll put that in the description. Make watches my emails and then my emails are put into a particular category. This email is a specific email when I work with certain clients. Sometimes the companies will give me an email issued by the company. So we'll say my name at that company. So those are the emails I monitor. I don't do this with my personal emails because anything you get to a lot of these technologies, you gotta assume that somebody's reading it or someone has access to it. So be really, really careful about personal information that you don't want shared. So I use these with my accounts that are corporate accounts that don't have any confidential information in them. So know that, right? So we are helpful assistant label my emails based on SOW, which is the scope of work, appointments, and spam. And it will determine if it falls in that category based on the subject line and the content. And that's what's given to OpenAI. Here's a router. And of those things, if it's a SOW, it'll send an email to me personally so that I'll know to go check into that particular company's email and do what I need to do there. Or if it is an appointment, it will automatically schedule it on my calendar. And if it is spam, it'll automatically move that email into my spam folder. So this makes my email inbox a lot less chaotic, and it's making sure I don't miss those important emails from my companies that I contract with that I may not necessarily interact with the email every single day. Another way that AI can help you be more productive is help you with time management. So let's look at this. I would like to spend this 3-day weekend accomplishing the following tasks: a 4-hour-a-day study, create a new lead magnet for consulting clients, and wash the deck, take 2 hours. If my day starts at 7:30 a.m. and ends at 10 p.m. for the next 3 days, can you give me a possible daily time block schedule for the 3-day weekends to accomplish my goals? Absolutely, I can help you create a time block schedule for your 3-day weekend. Let's break down your task and allocate time for each, considering your day starts at 7:30 and ends at 10 p.m. Study for 4 hours, create a lead magnet. Day one, this gives you a whole breakdown as to what you can do and even puts in time for breaks, free time breaks, dinner break, relaxation, and personal time breaks. So following this schedule, considering what you want to accomplish, this can really help you with your time management. You can just move around what doesn't and does work for you, but it's better than starting off from a clean slate. Okay, now let's talk my favorite, travel. Now here, I tend to go to Google Bard because I love that it coordinates with Google Maps and Google Flights and Google Hotels. So usually when I'm looking at travel, at least initially, I'm coming to Google Bard. So I'd like to go to Rome, Italy in late January for 3 nights. I would like to stay in the part of the city where restaurants that have a customer star rating of 4 or higher. I'd like to stay in a 3-star hotel that has customer ratings of 4 or higher. I would like the trip to be less than 600 euros. This should include hotel and flight. Now, because it gives all this information, it gives me some insight. There are flights around trips from Lisbon to Rome in the late January that are less than $600. So here are some flight options from Lisbon to Rome, $35, $49. All of that sounds reasonable. Some hotels that have 4-star ratings or higher. Here are some options. And this is giving me some pictures so I can quickly glance at what looks nice. Next, can you give me an itinerary revolving around shopping, dining, and seeing some tourist attractions? Please provide one map of the recommended experiences. So this is telling me day one what I can do, the various things. Day two, what I can do, the various things based on what I like to do. Here's a map of the recommended experience. It lists all of the experience, and then this gives you a map. This right here is the reason why I come to Google for my travel. This is critical because this takes away hours when it comes to planning what you want to do if you go that detailed. So the great thing about this is you can open this in Google Maps. So you can see where everything is located so that you can plan accordingly and make the most efficient use of your time when you're traveling. If there's a bunch of tourist attractions or shopping that's close to you, you can literally create a plan that makes more sense geographically. So my favorite part of this is then when you open this in Google Maps, now you get a map and you get even more information. Let's say if you want to know the restaurants that are around there, you can base that based on where you're located. You can find the various restaurants, what type of cuisine. You can get a plethora of information, saving you tons of time when you are planning your travel. So one of the other ways that you can use AI is to plan your networking and socializing throughout the year. Let me show you what I mean. Can you search online for conferences or events that I may want to go to for engineers? Please provide the dates and locations in a table format. So when I type this, it didn't put it in a table format for me, but fine, it still gave me the information, so I'm okay. So here's a comprehensive list of upcoming engineer conferences in 2024, organized by month and location. Do you know how much time that would have taken me? Okay, in the US, we have New York in January 2004. The 28th is the date of the International Conference of Various Engineering Disciplines. In February, we have a variety of things that are happening in Arlington, New York, and New York, and Washington, and for engineers, going to May and what have you. And so the great thing about this is here, it's citing the sources in which it got the information. So if you wanna find out any information and you wanna register, you can literally go to the conferences in which they're sourced. So this can take seconds in a matter of what would have taken you maybe hours if you were doing this manually. So this can help you network and socialize in your career so that you can meet the people that you need to meet. Another way that AI can help you have a productive 2024 is you get to automate your boring tasks. So here is Make, which is basically an API website. Zapier, if you ever heard of that, they basically do the same thing. But this is a no-code solution that you can connect various technologies together so that you can automate a lot of your processes. So we won't do a tutorial here. If you want me to do one, I will, but I want to tell you the ways that I use Make to automate boring things. So one of the boring tasks that I have automated that has made life so much easier is blog writing. So for me and a good amount of my clients, now we can automate this process and cut down costs drastically because we don't have to pay as many writers. So we put the information that's important in a Google Sheet. That information then goes to help create the outline and then the introduction and various parts of the article until we get to the end and it gets to WordPress. Now, this process isn't necessarily needed as much because OpenAI has upgraded and you now have a little bit more tokens to work with. But after all of that, it automatically will create the posts on WordPress. So that's one of the boring tasks that I've automated and that I love. Automated is transcribing. So when I take a language class or a meeting, I can automatically transcribe the information. And this has been ideal. If you're interested in doing that, look at OpenAI's Whisper. If you want a tutorial on that, just let me know in the comments. You can even use AI to be a personal virtual shopper. I'm looking for an outfit for my high school reunion. Can you help me find the following? A black pencil skirt, a white button-down shirt, a pair of black 4-inch heels. So here are some of the options that it gave me. This is not black, maybe it comes in black as well. A wrap pencil skirt that is flattering, easy to wear. A bodycon pencil skirt, that's more of my style. And then it gave me some options. White button-down shirt. So this was really helpful and this happened in a matter of seconds. And guys, this is as bad as it gets. AI is going to continue to improve to make your life even more easier with personalized shopping. So get ready for that.